Hello and welcome back to Xenoblade Chronicles X, where I'm a little bit sicker than I was last time, but the show must go on. So please do please do bear with me. I apologize for if I sound different than normal, or if I'm a little sniffly, or if I do some coughing. Thankfully, it doesn't hurt to talk, which is nice. In fact, it doesn't hurt to do anything. But yeah, there's definitely some unpleasantness going on. But yes, the show must go on. I don't want to miss my uploads, because I've never missed one yet. I've only been late during a day. So yeah. Anyway, I did a little bit of grinding for stuff between episodes, because I noticed a little something. So I went out and grabbed some stuff in relation to it. And then I just did some generic grinding that had been recommended to me, specifically to get myself as ready as I could to purchase the Ares something or other skill. I've heard it's good. It's not in my development thing, but I went and got everything I could for it. Apparently I need to get farther in the story to get the rest of everything. But yeah, as you can see, my class has changed, which mainly just got me an extra skill point because I finished that off. So now I'm just over here. So yeah, extra skill point, maybe higher stuff, stats, those things. But I'm still using the same gear I was. And yeah. What else did I do? Oh, right. The thing that I had noticed that got me off onto the grindy tangent in the first place is over here. Take a look at that ranged accuracy. It's pretty nice, isn't it? Yeah, you see, I noticed that those range accuracy 20 augments I could make if I just got some Swid Tails, which, I mean, those are not hard at all to get. You just gotta go fight the low-level Swids out in Primordia starting town. Not town, but starting area. So, yeah, it was basically just a matter of go out there and commit some Swid genocide, I suppose. Did a little bit of a Swid cull and got myself 10 of those, so now my skill and all my ally skills have much more ranged accuracy than they did before. And I should certainly hope that over 1,000 ranged accuracy is enough for things. Oh, hello. Heart-to-heart info, huh? That's neat. All right, Camber. I did the thing.
Hey, Camber, are these what you need?
Yeah, these things and these things.
Yeah, this should cover the repairs. Thanks so much, Alexa.
No sweat. I still owe you from before. If you want, I...
Alexa, Tika wants you. Sounds like she has another test lined up.
Oh, thanks. I'll go check it out. You'll come too, right? Bye, you two. Good luck with your tests.
Yeah.
We'll do our best.
Hey, Skell.
Drop by and see us again soon, Alexa.
Walk in front of the shot. All right. So, technically, I'm recording this while there are still some Xenoblades and some Twilight Princesses left to go up that I recorded while I was sick already. So you may be wondering why I'm recording again right now, and it's because, well, since I feel a little bit sicker than I did earlier, I kind of want to get ahead of the game before I get sicker still, in case that happens. And also, I'm specifically recording this first because there are cutscenes where people talk, and therefore I can afford to be more quiet. So yeah, just some of the things you gotta think about when you're sick, but you've got a video schedule to keep. So, yeah.
Sorry to make you wait.
Well, you're cheerier than I expected. I figured you'd still be moping. That's why I put a rush on the next job.
Aw, that's sweet. But yeah, Cambridge Skell is ready for repairs. Things are pretty much back to normal.
I hope you're not getting his hopes up.
Huh? About what?
Anyway, back to the task at hand. I have a new prototype for you folks to try out.
More ground gear?
I only work on skill tech for maybe 1 in 5 projects. I know you'd prefer the opposite, but them's the breaks. I'd like you to use the prototype on the indigens I specify. There are 2 sites this time. I need to make sure it can handle different weather and terrain.
Makes sense. We're on it, Tika.
So with that, I hope you're not getting his hopes up bit. I'm thinking Camber might have a thing for Alexa here. But we'll have to see, won't we? So, spark jet rifle. I mean, I guess I can equip that. Does Alexa use rifles? She does. So, let's go to assault rifles. I'm assuming it's... Yep, there it is. That is some nice TP gain. Hot damn. And I was actually told that the ramjet rifle... Oh yeah, that is nice TP gain. It doesn't do a damn thing for attack, but that is very nice TP gain. So... Yeah. Alright, so... Canyon Cantors in Silvalum at nighttime. And some jerkbag in Caldros, regardless of time. So let's head to Caldros first. Oh, hey, it's... It's that, Potamus that I've killed like 50 times now. I remember him. So, let's get over to him. It's not far, so we won't even fly. Oh. Who ran over something? You really need to watch where you're driving, people. So yeah, it's this guy right here. Now, the way this works is that the person using the weapon has to hit it at least once. But other than that, whatever can happen. So, doesn't matter if I kill him fast, slow, somewhere in between. So I imagine we've probably already gotten in the hit we needed. I certainly hope so. Oh, I was quite behind him there. Okay.
You messed with the wrong secretary.
We did, in fact, get the stuff. Ooh, some hot Potamus juice. That sounds delightful. So now we need it to be nighttime, which it should be short. Well, not too shortly. It's only 5 p.m. now. And I don't think evening counts as nighttime. So let's see. Oh good, there's a time changer pretty close to where the cantors are. So, let's... Hang on a second. Okay, that Zedom's going away. But it's a squad task, so I might as well be nice. We can kill it. Killing some Zedoms is actually a lot of what I was doing during my grinding. Also, I noticed that I had another weapon that I could use on my Skell. In place of the E-Sight, this rifle. A, takes advantage of our ranged attack. B, does about as much damage as the E-Sight did when attacking from behind. And C, it has a shorter cooldown. And in fact, I think we just found another one. Let's take a look at it real quick. Yeah, we did just found another one. And we've also got some G2 busters. Those are nice, except for... apparently they hit twice, which is nice, but the cooldown's not great. Why does... oh, because one's 40 and one's a 50, I guess, is why one does more damage. Though they both have the same level requirement. That's weird. Wonder what determines the difference. Anyway, let's go find those cantors. And the fact that I say before remembering the name Cantor keeps making me think of a cantor in Monster Hunter. So apparently they would be down here, but all I see is this false axum, which we might as well kill, provided it notices we're here. There. Alright, this should kill it. Excellent. And now we can, at our leisure, open this thing. Hooray, we opened that thing. Oh, there's one of the cantors that we need. So we actually need to be out of our skull. And we need specifically Alexa out of hers. We ourselves do not have to be out of ours. Okay. I want to find more breakables. Oh, I'm already on them. That's nice. Okay. There's one. Hooray, we got things. Ah, there's more. That's right, it had to be nighttime. Well, I guess that false axum was nice enough to help us get it to be nighttime. I had forgotten that I was going to a time changer. Okay. Here's your back. There it is. Alright, two down. How did I get a luminescent tail? Do these things even have tails? Seems they've got just those little spikes. I mean, I guess if that's supposed to serve as a tail. And there we go. Excellent. So back to the test hangar we go. Oh, but she's inside now. Not that that changes really anything at all. Alright, lady, where are you? Right about here? There you are.
Hey.
Hi. Sure. I guess I need to take it off Alexa then. So let's once again look at assault rifles. Okay, highest level thing, or rather, best thing she can equip. Let's find it. Would this be it? I'd imagine so. Yeah, looks like it. All right.
Nice data gathering, guys. Can I have the prototype back?
There you go.
This thing was amazing. Not that I'm surprised, coming from you.
Alexa, did you notice anything off about the gun?
off?
Yeah. Looking at the data, it's like there's some bug or contaminant.
Well, I suppose it is getting kind of hot.
Lose it now!
Oh, is it? Yeah.
Jeez! That was close! Are you alright?
Fine. I guess even you slip up sometimes, huh, Tika?
Yes, but not like that. That was intentional. Sabotage.
And it's a wonder it waited till now.
Is there anyone who'd want to see you get hurt?
No way, you guys!
Yes, way. And if I'm right, they already had it out for you before that failed test.
You really think it's sabotage?
Prototypes can be unstable, but we check for safety.
And suddenly the music cut out.
Field tests. Yet you've just been at the center of two potentially fatal accidents in a row.
Fatal? You mean I almost... Holy cheeseballs, that's crazy! But who would be doing it?
I have no clue. That said, I may have a way of finding out.
Really?
I'll analyze what's left of the prototype. That may tell me what they did to it.
Thanks, Tika. You're the best.
Just give me a minute here. Got it. They planted a micro-explosive in the stock. It had a radio receiver that was detonated remotely.
So, if they'd hit the button while it was on my back...
You'd be little bits on the wall.
Holy crap!
So since they didn't kill you, murder doesn't seem to be the motive. They just want your missions to fail. And by fail, I mean explode.
That's almost worse!
I don't know about that, but it is a clue. To time the detonation like that, they'd have to be watching you.
Oh my gosh. I have a stalker? Seriously?
No.
Good plan. If we can find the witness, we may be able to find the mystery creep.
Watch Alexa's back for me, will you? And maybe your own, too.
You got it. So yeah, it's definitely nice that the gun heats up before exploding. And oh boy. Oh, fled toward the diner, but it's so quick. You didn't see your face. Okay.
That's crazy.
So let's head towards the diner then, I suppose. Anyone else got some info? Doesn't look like it. But we know it was a woman, and she went toward the diner. So...
Do I have to spell it out?
About you?
I can help.
Toward the administrative district. Why there? Like, that's not close to here. That's... Well, I guess it's straight down this road. Let's head that way. Maybe we'll find someone with more info. Oh, we are leaving the search area, but there's a quest to turn in. Whoop, whoop. Okay, we didn't fall too far. Hi.
Mika.
Oh, Alexa. What are you doing here?
What are you doing here, Mika?
Yeah? I hear another prototype blew up on you. You okay?
Right as rain. Oh my gosh. It was you!
I'm sorry. I planned to do it when I was sure no one would get hurt. But then time was short and I just... panicked.
Why did you do it, Mika?
Because I hate you, okay? I hate you!
Look, if this is about Camber's Skell, I'm trying to make it up to you. I'll do whatever!
That's why I hate you. I've been Camber's friend since back on Earth. But then we get here, and within 2 months you've got him wrapped around your finger. I know this is totally bitter, and I should have made a move, but you just walked in with your hair and your attitude and went for it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Help me out here. Why is she mad at me?
Yeah, that's the thing right there. Let's explain it.
Oh, got it. Got it. Wow, you are really not smart, Mika.
Don't lie to me. You come waltzing by almost every day to chat up Camber. And he just eats it up, the fool. Then you charge off to get spare skull parts so he'll like you more. Just to show how sweet and dedicated you are. Don't tell me that's just a coincidence.
Oh, come on. That's stupid.
It is not stupid!
I don't love Camber. I love his skull. The reason I visit you guys all the time is to look at your gear. And I only wanted to get those parts because the idea of a wrecked skull makes me totally sad.
You've got to be kidding me.
Honestly, the only love in my life is giant robots.
A true gearhead.
Come on, help me out here. This lady is crackers.
I don't know about that. I mean, she's right for her, I guess, but... not gonna tease her. Yeah, it's Mika's fault.
This is really all in my head?
It is.
Yep.
Oh, wow. I'm sorry. To both of you. I made a huge mess of this.
And what about the people behind us?
Don't worry about it. No one got hurt, right?
It doesn't matter. I've been a fool.
I'll forgive you if you promise to let me take your skull for a spin sometime.
That's all you want?
All? That's huge!
You've got yourself a deal. Just don't break it.
Yay! You got it.
Alexa's fun. And it doesn't cease to amuse me that these affinity missions will pretty much only pay attention to the characters who are required to be there, specifically your character and whatever other characters are mandatory for the mission, which is why poor Celica and Nagi just got completely ignored there. Anyone who's not mandatory for the mission, since they can just be subbed out, they'll just hang out behind everyone else and never be addressed. It's kind of silly. Anyway, we've got still more stuff that we can do. In fact, let's check our affinity chart, because I know we can do a mission for Nagi at this point. Yeah, we're at 4 hearts with him. Damn. Celica, we're getting close. How are we doing with Alexa now? Okay, just 3 hearts. I don't even know where I would find another affinity mission with her anyway. And Yelv, we definitely can't because we haven't been using him. But yeah, there's definitely some stuff we can do. So, let's head on up to... Jeez, where is Nagi's mission? That requires us to have Elma and Lynn, does it? Well, then maybe that can wait. So it's looking like pretty much everything requires us to have Elma and Lynn. At least everything that we qualify for based on our affinity with people. Kinda wish we had something else. Something that we could do without needing Elma and Lynn on board. Would be nice, but I don't know that we've got any such thing. I'm just checking around the map, seeing and hoping. Yeah, the closest we've got to needing someone that I care about at the moment is we've got one for Celica, but we don't have quite enough affinity with Celica to do it. So yeah, I guess let's head on back to the Blade Barracks and get Elma and Lynn into the party so that we can do some of these other affinity missions. Hang on a sec. I just want to real quick take a look at our missions. Alright. Yeah, that... it's not a go talk to specific people thing. It's... this is apparently you gotta go around talking to everyone, so it probably will not be done for a long time. I mean, like, a long, long time. And actually, before we swap out for Elma and Lynn, I am taking one more trip back to the administrative district just to check the quest board, and then I'm going to check on that one murderous mission, because I may or may not have done the mission that it required by now. I don't even remember what it was called. So let's see what we've got on here. It's looking like not really anything terribly interesting, which is pretty standard by this point. Yeah. Nothing. But hey, that just means that we've done a lot of the stuff that is interesting. So at least there's that. Getting up there in Meranium, not that I've got too much to spend it on. So, let's just see whether we've met the progress requirements. Looks like we have, maybe. So let's warp on back over to the other side of the administrative district. And then pick up Murderous. And we can slot her in for Nagi. Because Nagi is already where he needs to be for us to do his next things. And in fact, at 4 hearts, I think if we do all of his heart-to-hearts, that might get us to 5 as is.
Let's go.
So yeah. Plus, he's level 60 anyway, so he is gaining nothing but affinity for being with us. So, Murderous on the team, Nagi off the team. And why am I running there? I can just warp there. Warping there is better. So, let's check this out. Let's see what's going on. Oh. It would have been nice if you told me the progress requirements hadn't been met before I went and grabbed Murderous here. So how do I get my hands on the Haywire mission? I kind of want to know, and I think I'll check it out between episodes and just see what prereqs it's got. And looking at the time, I feel like this is a pretty decent place to end this episode. So yeah, join us next time when either we'll try and get the Haywire mission or we'll get Nagi back on the team along with Lynn and Elma and go do his affinity mission. We'll find out next time which one we do, so I will see you then, friends.